Hello, how are you? Welcome. Welcome. How are you going? Good to see you. That's lovely. Hello, how are you? Welcome. Another edition of 3, 2, 1 for the pot. Now this will bring you into the market.
And don't forget the Happy Habit.
And remember, Kitchener wants you. And welcome to News at 10.
And 180.
And a quick Harvey Smith.
Just a minute.
What?
You'll be wanting to take over the quiz now.
That's the whole idea.
Good idea.
Taking over the show, you see.
Oh, you like to do that?
Oh, yes.
Well, I'll tell you what. If you're going to do that, let me give you a question.
Yes.
What do you call two cheeky fellas who want to take my place?
I don't know. What do you call two cheeky fellas who want to take your place?
Redundant. Now get off.
Oh!
Thank you. Chris Emmett, Mike Newman, you'll be seeing just a bit later on. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another session of Family Fun that we call 3-2-1. Show that's got variety, variation, and valuable prizes. But one booby prize, remember? Here's the household hardware with a handmaiden. Dusty bin with Karen Palmer. Now, Dusty's dressed up as an Arab because the theme of our show this week is that Fortis classic film by Humphrey Bogart, Casablanca. But right now, here is Dusty and the girls to introduce, as always, the most important people on our program, our contestants.
From Birmingham, please welcome Frank and Jill Hubble. And from Lincoln, here are Adrian and Judy Stafford. And from Harrogate, Gordon and Linda Thompson.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Well, as always, we do start on 3-2-1. We remember with our quiz, that's three couples there. We then come to our elimination game with two couples down to one couple who have a chance to go through where all the big prizes can be won. So let's meet our first couple tonight. We've got Gordon and Linda, and you're from... Gordon and Linda Thompson from Harrogate? Not far away, in Yorkshire, yes. Okay, Gordon, what line of work are you in?
I'm a sales engineer in the industrial valve business.
The
oil and chemical industry.
Oil and chemical, big business, oil, yes?
It is, yeah, very big at the moment.
Uh-huh.
Very good.
Do you get to travel at all?
Yes, quite a lot, all over this country and into America.
America?
Like that, yes.
Do you go there very often?
Well, not often, once a year, hopefully.
Oh, that's hard, isn't it? Just once a year. Oil, do you get down to Dallas at all?
Right, no, Houston.
Not far away. You don't have anything to do with Ewing Oil, do you?
Nothing to do with JR at all, no.
Because I've actually found out what JR stands for, Jovial Rat. But we love it, eh? He's a lovely guy. Linda, you're a housewife and a mother, and how many children do you have?
Two. A little boy, two, and a little boy, 6 months.
Uh-huh, 6 months, so quite a young family. And when you did work, what did you do?
I was a personal assistant to a company that made canoes. And canoeing films.
Before that, you worked for a dog food firm as well?
After that.
Oh, that was afterwards?
Afterwards, yes. I went to a dog food manufacturer.
That wasn't PAL, Prolonged Active Life?
No. Much better.
Much better.
Yes.
There's a new one now, you know, that contains LBW. That's Lega Barbara Woodhouse. It's quite nice. Let's have your questions. With your questions, it's Alison Temple Savage with your questions. How are you? Lovely.
I'm fine, Edward. I've been shopping in the Christmas sales.
How have you been doing?
Oh, very well. I found something that's guaranteed to keep down my heating bills.
What was that?
A paperweight.
About the only thing that would, I would think. Would you like to choose your questions, please, Gordon? Here we are, just one of those. Thank you very much, Alison. Now, you know in the first round you play for £10 each correct answer, whatever the amount is at the end of the first round, what you play for each correct answer in the second. If you don't know an answer, please say don't know. Once you've made a mistake, I have to stop you there, all right? But we do let you have one to start with, you know. Now, this question is about initials used in the world of television and radio. Now, we want to give you the sets of initials, and we want you to say what they stand for, all right? Now, ATV, of course, stands for Associated Television, so that's the one we'll start you with. ATV is...
Associated Television.
LWT.
London Weekend Television.
IBA.
Independent Broadcasting Association.
I'm afraid I have to make a mistake for you there, yes. It's not quite right. It was Independent Broadcasting Authority, not Association. I'm afraid we have to take the first answers right. But you do have two, and you've got £20. So it's not too bad. Well done. Don't worry about it. Take your time. Plenty of time.
Here we've got Jill and Frank. Jill and Frank Hubble from Harborne, Birmingham. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Jill and Frank Hubble. What do you do, Frank Hubble?
Teach. Teach in a special school for delinquent boys.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you help boys who are in trouble, Hubble? What do you do for sort of hobbies? And don't say you dabble in Scrabble, Hubble, because I won't have them. What do you do, Frank?
I wouldn't dream of saying such a thing.
No, only me would do that.
I couldn't get my tongue around it. Art and craft, mainly. Biggest hobby at the moment is Round Table.
Really? Now, that's a marvellous and enterprising organisation. Does a lot of good work for a lot of good people. And Jill, what sort of work do you do?
Part-time chemical worker.
And who's that for?
Electrical wholesalers.
I see. So you're Jill Hubble, electrical in clericals. No, clerical in electricals.
That's right.
I see. And what about the way you two met? That was rather strange, wasn't it?
Yes, it was rather. a friend and I went out for a drink one night. Sat on one side of a table. Jill and two of her friends came and sat at the other side of the table. Annoyed us by getting served first. And Jill, just having a drink, nice, quiet drink. Friend said something. And there was me.
All over you?
All over.
Oh, that's a nice introduction, isn't it? Soiled your clothes, huh?
Yes.
Hubble bubble soil and trouble. OK, let's have your questions. And it's Libby. This is Libby Roberts. Hey, Libby, that's better. A nice smile now, but a little earlier on today, you weren't looking too good. Why was that?
Well, I had a letter from my bank manager saying that I was £50 overdrawn. Really? It really shocked me.
I bet. What did you do?
I sent him a cheque.
Well, that would clear it, wouldn't it? Yes. Select your questions, please, would you? Thank you, Jill. OK, Libby. Right, OK, you've got just a 20 to beat at the moment. Don't forget, answer alternately. If you don't know an answer, please say don't know. Now, this question for you is about initials all connected with the law and order. I'll give you the initials. You tell me what they stand for. Now, CIA stands for Central Intelligence Agency, so that's the one we'll start you with. CIA is?
Central Intelligence Agency.
FBI.
Federal Bureau of Investigation.
CID.
Criminal. No, pass.
PC.
Police Constable.
QC.
Queen's Counsel.
JP.
Justice of the Peace.
DPP.
Don't know.
HMP.
Her Majesty's Prison.
D.A.
District Attorney.
G.B.H.
Grievous Bodily Harm.
Right, not bad at all there at the end of that round. Yes, a couple you didn't know. Just two. Two you didn't know. D.P.P. was Director of Public Prosecutions, C.I.D. Criminal Investigation Department, but I think you've got eight there, so you have. £80. Well done. That's it. Okay. Here we've got Adrian and Judy Stafford from Lincoln. It's not Adrian and Judy Lincoln from Stafford, is it?
No.
No. I see. And from your details here, Adrian, it says you're a general builder. But tell everybody, there's a reason here for it. You're a builder, but you like gales.
Gales and natural disasters. Anything that's good for business.
Yeah. See, blame him for it, will you? That's private enterprise going well, I'm sure. And Judy, when did you first have a night out in the tiles, if you pardon the expression, with Adrian?
Oh, 10, 11, 12 years ago.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I see. Just 10, 11, 12 years. I see. And you met at a disco, yes?
Yes.
And it says it was a mistake. Now, what was the mistake?
Well, I went to meet somebody else, but he met him first and told him not to come, and he came instead.
Oh. So not only does he likes to suffer from disasters, you got rid of the fellow who was going to go out with her?
That's right, yeah.
Oh, lovely. And what's this fellow doing now that we're going to turn up?
We've lost him now.
Not doing a lot of it.
Right. Let's have your questions, and Fiona Curzon has your question. Hi, Fiona. Earlier on this morning, I saw you with a new boyfriend. What's he like?
Yes, he's super.
Is he?
But he's very conceited. Do you know he has his initials on his handkerchiefs?
Well, lots of people have their initials on handkerchiefs.
Not paper ones.
That's conceit, wouldn't it be? Yes, let's have your questions. Thanks a lot, Fiona. Okay, Judy, thank you. Now then, here we go. You're round here. Don't forget, we let you have one to start with. This question is about jobs and occupations that are often referred to by two letters. We will give you the two letters. We want you to give us the name of the job. Now, the one we'll let you have to start with is CE, which is civil engineer. So CE is?
Civil engineer.
DJ.
Disc jockey.
CO.
Clerical officer.
No, I'm afraid it is commanding officer.
We can accept that? OK, yes, we can accept it. Good, clerical officer. OK, S-R-N.
State Registered Nurse.
Right. A-B. M-C.
Master of Ceremonies.
M-P.
Minister of Parliament.
Well, again, I've got Member of Parliament, yes. We've got to accept Member, I'm afraid. Nevertheless, just a mistake, Member of Parliament. There we are. What have we got there, then? We've got one we didn't know, AB, which was able-bodied seaman, by the way. So you've got one, two, three, four, five. I think £50 we should have. We have. £50. Well so, at the end of the first round, we have got couple number one, Linda and Gordon, they're on £20. Couple number three here, Adrian and Julie, on 50. In the lead at the moment are Jill and Frank, £80. OK, Linda. Linda and Gordon, £20. Select your questions for each correct answer this time, would you?
Go on, you do it.
Yes. He chose them last time. Thanks, Alison. Now then, get a maximum this time. What could we get? We could get 10 twos of 200. That wouldn't be bad. This question is about goodies and baddies. Goodies and baddies. We will give you the name of the character. We want you to tell us who played the character. Now, Sam Spade was played by Humphrey Bogart. So that's the one we'll start you with. Sam Spade was?
Humphrey Bogart.
Inspector Clouseau, who played Inspector?
Peter Sellers.
James Bond, who played James Bond?
Sean Connery.
Right. Superman, do you know who Superman was?
Don't know.
The Godfather, who played the Godfather?
Ryan Gosling.
Ned Kelly, who played Ned Kelly?
Don't know.
Wonder Woman.
Linda Carter.
The Incredible Hulk.
Don't know.
Hercule Poirot. No. Yeah? The $6 million man. We're out of time on the $6 million man, which you knew, I'm sure, was Lee Majors. It was, in fact. Hercule Poirot was Peter Ustinov or Albert Finney, of course. And what else? Lou Ferrigno was the Incredible Hulk. He's the fellow who goes a little green. Superman was played by Christopher Reeve. So therefore, you've got five right. So five twos, you have £100. Yeah. Right, Jill and Frank, please choose your questions. You're going for £80 for each correct answer this time. Your questions are these. This question is about crime fighters of various types from TV series. We will give you the name of the actor. We want you to tell us the series. Now, we'll start you with Telly Savalas. He is in Kojak, so it's Telly Savalas is in?
Kojak.
Peter Falk.
Columbo.
David Soul.
Starsky and Hutch.
Dennis Waterman.
Stone.
No, I'm afraid you're wrong. Dennis Waterman, the Sweeney or Minder. You were thinking of Dennis Weaver.
No.
I had him to come. I'm afraid you've got three there. Those three eights are 24. You've got £240. £240 is right.
Thank you.
Well done. OK. There's Adrian and Judith's questions. Thank you very much, Fiona. All right, now let's see what we have for you this time. This question is about arch villains and baddies. We will give you a clue to the character. We want you to give us the name of the villain. We'll start you with Batman. Now, the villain in Batman is the Riddler. So it's Batman and...
The Riddler.
Dr. Jekyll.
Mr. Hyde.
Who's the villain in Dallas?
J.R.
Oliver Twist.
Don't know.
Popeye.
Don't know.
Flash Gordon.
Ming.
Peter Pan. Who's the villain?
Don't know.
Sherlock Holmes.
Don't know.
Robin Hood.
The Sheriff of Nottingham.
Star Wars. Who was the villain
Don't
in Star
know.
Wars? Ah, right, well, that's 10 there. So the villain was Darth Vader in Star Wars. The villain in Sherlock Holmes was Moriarty, the fool. Peter Pan, of course, it was Captain Hook.
Captain, yes.
Yes, now she knows. Popeye, the villain there was Pluto. Oh, now you know. And Oliver Twist, it was Bill Sykes or Fagin. I've got there 3, 4, 5. Is that right? Yes, £250 is what you have.
Well done.
At the end of the quiz, what do we got? We have Linda and Gordon on £100. We've got Jill and Frank on £240. But the winners of the quiz this week, Adrian and Judy, £250. It's always a shame to have to lose one of our couples because they always are lovely, delightful people that come on our show. It's been great having you with us, Gordon and Linda. Sorry it's ended so quickly, but it seemed like an eternity to you, I'm sure, isn't it? It was only that third one in the first round that got you, but you've got, what, £80? No, £100 you've got.
There it is. All in fivers. Give it to you, a very chivalrous man. There's your ceramic bin, though. Whatever you do, don't drop him. Thank you very much, Gordon. Thank you, Linda. Take care. See you soon. Lovely. Right. OK, ladies and gentlemen, back after the break on 3-2-1. See you then. Don't go far, will you? Here we are, part two, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. We're about to play the 3-2-1 video elimination game. We've got Jill and Frank from Birmingham playing Adrian and Judy from Lincoln. Now, you know what happens at the bottom of your screens here? You know you have a bat, which can be moved from left to right by using the control stick. The object is to hit the ball against the wall. You'll score every time you hit the wall. If you manage to break through, believe me, those points really will build up for you. The only thing is, of course, when a ball does go out of play, you must pass the control stick to your partner who continues playing. Naturally, the one with the highest amount of points will go through to part three with a chance to take home something really good tonight. Who's playing first out of Adrian and Judy? Adrian, well done. Good luck to you. And what about you and then Jill and Frank? Frank is playing first, the men.
Thank you.
Okay, you know we have a red light here in the middle which will start to flash. When that does, of course, we're on the last few seconds of the game. So good luck to you. Here we go. 3-2-1, away we go. We are flashing now the last few seconds of the game. All right, hold it just there. Will you hold it? That's the end of the game. Thank you very much. Put the control sticks down. Let's see how we've done. Now, Adrian and Judy.
22, actually.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. That's the score you've got. Well, that's got a computer, remember. That's the score you have, which is 26. And Jill and Frank here have got 29. They're the winners. So well done. See? That's nice. That's what I like. That's really honesty. He says there was only 22 there, but you did have a few more points. But you got the money in the quiz. What was that, Karen?
£250.
£250 they won. There's your ceramic dusty. Your leather photo frame. Don't forget, there's been a photograph taken of you, and there's your video game to take home and play at home. Thanks a lot, Adrian. Thank you very much, Julia.
Thank you.
Good luck. Take care. Good luck to you. Have a good time. Congratulations. Well, of course, that means, Jill and Frank, you're going through with the chance to take home something really good tonight. You know what happens? We've got five items to show you, and we've got five prizes. You know there are four good ones, and there's a booby, old, dusty bin. Win him, of course, that's all you take home. A brand new dustbin. But at the moment, you've also got the money you won in the quiz, which was about 240, wasn't it? Well, that's good. As I told you, at the end of each of our items, we shall be at my table. One of the characters will leave you a clue object, read you a rhyme. When you've got three on the table, you'll reject one. When you've rejected four, the one that remains will tell you what prize is going home with you tonight. And at the top of the show, I told you that the theme was Casablanca. A great Hollywood movie, of course, Casablanca, made in the 40s. It was a notable film for several reasons, the acting, the story, a certain song, and here to sing that certain song is that very lovely lady, Marion Montgomery.
Just a kiss, a sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still
There's Jill and Frank both saying super, and it was as ever, sensational. Mwah. Singing better than ever. I thought you could have got a better pianist tonight, though, didn't you?
Well, I tried, but, you know, we couldn't find one who would fit the suit.
Lovely Laurie Holloway, only Marion's husband, that was all. Lovely guy. Great to see you, as always. Marion, a very busy lady.
Yes,
And what are you up to right now?
Well, I'm in Australia, and going to be going around the world, so I'm rather excited about that, and come back in April at the Festival Hall.
Well, good luck with all of that. And what about a little clue then for Frank and Jill here?
I have a rather large clip right there.
A clip, see? Here, clip. And what about the rhyme? What does that
say? I've got the rhyme. Now then, you must remember this, but in case you might forget, you'll have this to remind you. You'll see it on the set.
Hey, now then, Frank, Jill. What do you think? A suitcase and a grip.
On the set, plenty of cameras about.
Pretty well, yes, you could win a camera, Frank, you never know. But will you please say, Marion Montgomery.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Marion. Bye-bye, darling.
Bye-bye.
All the best. So, plenty of cameras about. No idea what it could be, though, have you at the moment?
No,
you should reserve
so
judgment on that and have a good look. He's having a good look right
have
now.
Have a good look there and see what's there.
That's it, yes. Okay, I'll tell you what, we'll move on then and have our next item. We'll carry on with this little screen version of Casablanca. As you may have guessed, here tonight we've allowed ourselves just a little bit of TV license.
Sam, I thought I told you never to play that in here. What do you think this is, a Chinese restaurant? Don't play it again, Sam.
Well, what would you like me to play, me old flower?
Go through the book, Sam. Pick out something suitable.
Righto, me old loves.
Hi, Rick.
Hi, friend. Or in your case, low friend.
Little things mean a lot.
Rick, my old friend, I'd like
to get you on a slow boat to China.
No, I'd like you to get me
a ticket to ride.
Out.
Out of town?
Yeah.
You need
hands.
A miracle.
Couldn't you fly me
to the moon and let me play among the stars?
Listen, why don't you
roam, rabbit, roam, rabbit, roam, roam.
Yeah, get out.
And get under. Get out and get under.
Will you stop playing that thing? Rick, my friend, right now I'm the most wanted man in Casablanca.
Congratulations.
And it's going to get worse.
As time goes by.
Sam, don't play that song. You know the one I want to hear.
Oh, Rick. Don't ask me to play that.
Listen, Sam, you played it for her, you played it for him. You played it for him and him and him. And him and him and him and him and him. Now you can play it for me. Play the song, Sam.
All right, Flower. You've asked for it. After three. A one, a two, a three.
On il primo batat. On il primo batat. On il primo
What are you going to leave? What's your clue?
Well, first of all, I'm going to leave you a button.
A button?
Yeah.
Right.
And then I'm going to do a little rhyme. I wasn't going to read it at first.
No?
No, I was going to send a message on the drums.
Wouldn't have understood that.
He would have done, but you wouldn't.
I wouldn't have understood that.
Well, what does it say, he would have understood it being a foreigner, you see.
Well, you could have interpreted for him anyway. What does it say?
Now then, I don't know whether to... I'll put my posh act on now.
Oh, you will?
Posh voice.
All right.
When my auntie comes, my rich auntie, I talk like this.
You do?
When my other one comes, we just talk like that. A push on, not a walk on part. You've seen it once on shot. So take it nice and easy. So near, so far, so what?
There we are. What do you reckon, Jim?
Push on.
Push on?
Wheels.
Yeah, so what do you think it could be, Frank?
The bin.
Oh, really?
Oh, there you are. Well, that's what they've gone for straight away, but I'm sure you're going to thank Charlie Williams, ladies and gentlemen.
Cheers, Charlie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, mate.
Come on.
Push on, turn it once on the chest.
Well, Frank,
you think so? You think so? What do you think, Jim?
Push
she's not as convinced as you are there, Frank.
No, not yet.
Why, what are you... That's it, Jill's got the right idea. What, not yet, she says. Sit back, get them on the table, and then think about it. Mm. Make up your own mind. Yeah. Let's get back to Casablanca, where this time we drop in at the Cafe Americana. This time we find Rick with a companion who seems to have just a little bit of a problem.
You've won again, Rick.
I play chess like I play the game of life, little man. I cheat.
Oh.
What brings you to see me this time, friend?
I must leave Casablanca.
Oh, yeah? Well, you can't take it with you, kid.
No, the chief of police is after me.
You mean he collects garden gnomes? It's gonna cost you a lot of money to get out of Casablanca right now, friend.
Oh, I am short, Rick.
That's not gonna make it any cheaper.
But I have managed to get some documents which could be so embarrassing to those concerned that they'll get me out of here. I got them from two Germans.
Oh, yeah? The only thing I ever got from the Germans was measles.
I poisoned them, stabbed them, strangled them, chained them to two concrete blocks and dropped them into the harbor.
Why didn't you shoot them just to be on the safe side?
Oh, Rick, you know I hate violence. But I need your help, Rick. I need someone to look after the documents for me. It's my only chance.
Oh, yeah? 4 pound of carrots, 2 pound of onions, 2 pound of mince, 6 stone of radish. You get a lot of wind.
Oh, no. Sorry, that's my shopping list. These are the real documents.
Okay, good.
Thanks, Rick. Look out.
Silence! I'm looking for some important documents stolen from two colleagues of mine.
Oh, yeah? Then you've come to the right place, Herr Major.
Rick.
There you go.
How could you?
Always glad to be of some help to the SS captain.
Rick, you knew how important those documents were?
Only to a man who wants 2 pound of mince pie, 4 pound of onions, and 6 pound of radish. That's another fine stew I've got you out of.
Carl Rigg, of course, in a bit of a different rig out from what we get in Anstey's in Emmerdale Farm.
Anstey in Emmerdale Farm, yes.
Now, what are you going to leave then, Carl? What's the...
This is the documents.
The documents? Ali. That's going to be the clue, right?
Yes.
And what about the rhyme? What does that say?
The shopping list's been thrown away, but might arouse your fears. You could collect a lot in this, but will it lead to tears?
Now, any ideas, Jill?
Sounds like a car or a dustbin.
Ah, well, he thought the other one was a bin, but we've got to start to think about making up our minds and also thanking Carl Rigg. Thanks a lot, Carl. Well, Frank, the rules of the game, you've just heard that from Carl. Yeah. I can read you the button which Charlie Williams brought in, or the hair grip that was brought in by Marion Montgomery. You'd like to hear that, Jill? Okay.
I don't know what, Frank.
You know what? Well, you're just going to hear. Do you want to hear it, Frank?
Well, I'll be good.
You can't argue with me later. No.
Right.
Marion said, "You must remember this, but in case you might forget, you have this to remind you. You'll see it on the set." Now, a little while ago, you were saying something about cameras and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But what do you think? Can you remember what this one said that Charlie brought in?
Yes. Push on. Push on. Mm-hmm. Push on. The only thing I've seen pushed on. Is the bin.
Mm-hmm. And what about the one that Carl's just brought in, the documents? Any idea what that could be?
Documents, car documents, logbook.
Oh. Stinking pretty well, isn't it? Well, what do you think?
That one.
You want to reject that one?
The button.
Charlie Williams button?
Please.
Yes?
Yes.
What do you think about that, audience?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, good. They're all on your side tonight. Okay, you're rejecting Charlie Williams button, and Charlie said, a push-on, not a walk-on part. You've seen it once in on shot. You've seen it once on shot, so take it nice and easy. So near, so far, so what? So what is it? Push on, not a walk-on part. You've seen it once in shot. Well, what have you already seen that we could push on? You did say, Frank, it could be the bin. So take it nice and easy. So near, so far, so what? Well, part of it, in fact, is near. Part of it is a bit further away. Now, let's have a look. You could have taken it nice and easy in this leather armchair. Just have a look at this. It's beautiful. Beautiful. A beautiful, marvellous chair. It's real leather, by the way. But it didn't end there. There was one more just over here, if you'd like to take a look. Here we are. Look at that. The difference in the tires. Beautiful. And once again, this was it. There it was, yes. It was on set all the time. Most marvellous Chesterfield, a fabulous suite there. The whole thing is worth certainly £1,500 and a marvellous prize. I'm sure you'll agree, won't you, Frank?
Oh, definitely.
Yes, could you have done with that?
Just a bit.
Well, sit down. Just sit down, Frank. Sit down, Jill. See what it feels like. You know, you're not going
to
take it
home.
But it's not bad, is it, really? Don't worry. We'll sit back and relax and enjoy it for just a couple of minutes, and we'll see you after the break on 3-2-1. Don't go far now. Part three, ladies and gentlemen, where Frank and Jill from Birmingham have just rejected a magnificent Chesterfield suite, three-piece suite, marvellous prize. We're going to carry on with this magnificent 3-2-1 set of Casablanca. Just take a look at this. Over there we have Rick. He's having another drink, and he's about to have a romantic reunion.
He's looking at you, kid. Same again, friend.
Oui, monsieur.
I mean the same drink again, dummy. My God, the stuff we're getting out of this.
Hello, Rick.
You?
Me?
And you.
And me?
It's been a long time, Rick.
Yeah, kid. The service here is terrible.
Paris seems a long time ago.
Paris is a lifetime ago, Blue Eyes.
Do you think it's too late to try and recapture Paris, Rick?
No, it's too soon. The Germans only took it this afternoon.
I mean, you and me and Paris. What we had there was...
food poisoning from the shellfish?
Oh, the stolen moments on the left bank. The sound of the accordion players drifting across the Seine.
Yeah, I often did wonder who pushed them in.
I can still feel the tingle in your arms when you first held me in the metro.
Yeah, true. You see, I didn't realize I had my foot on the live rail.
Let's pretend we're back in Paris. Forget we've ever been separated. I know I'm still in love with you.
And me with me.
Let's pretend it's as it was in
1935. I was in Paris in 1933.
Oh, I'm sorry. I seem to have mistaken you for someone else.
Hello, how are you?
Humphrey Newman here. Lovely portrayal there, Mike.
Yes, it's quite interesting eating a cigarette.
That's the clue, is it?
That's the clue with this rather nice champagne glass.
And
this is the rhyme. Are they staying together, or are they ships that pass in the night? Can this really be love, or will everything turn out right?
There we are. What do you say to that one, Frank? Aye, is what he says. Thanks, Mike Newman.
Nice to see you. Take
care. Thanks a
lot.
Thank you. Cheers. Any idea at all?
Holidays? The ships, yes, passing. Yes, could be.
Could be. Well, I can read again the hair clip brought in by Marion there, or the documents brought in by Carl Rick. Which of those two would you like to hear?
Which one?
That
one, please.
You want to hear that one? Marion said, brought in the clip, and she said, you must remember this, but in case you might forget, you'll have this to remind you, you'll see it on the set. So,
yeah.
We have to reject one more. We've got rid of one marvellous prize tonight. We've got that bin to look out for, of course.
I think that's video equipment.
Yes?
See it on the set, have this to remind you as time goes by.
So, well, have you got a video?
No, I haven't.
Equipment at all?
No, we haven't.
You haven't? One's got to go. One has to be rejected.
What do you think?
Argue with each other. You know, it's entirely up to you.
This one?
He's going from one to the other.
Go on, then.
That one.
Do you want to get rid of the hair clip brought in by Marion?
Yes.
All right, okay, Marion's hair clip you're rejecting. You must remember this, but in case you might forget, you'll have this to remind you. You'll see it on the set. Now then, you must remember this in case you might forget. You'll have this to remind you. Or could this be a souvenir of the show? Could it, in fact, be the bin? We also said you see it on the set. Well, in fact, it isn't the bin, Frank. If you'd have won this prize, you were absolutely right. You'd have had this to have reminded you time and time again. This remote control color TV set and video recorder. Yes. There we are, look at that. A remote control, colour TV set, and the most marvellous video recorder. They're great machines. I can really, really recommend them. As you know, you can record anything you wanted. Are you a bit upset you've rejected that?
Just a little.
Just a little?
Yes.
Well, there's a few bob there too, Frank, I can tell you that. How about you, Jill? How do you feel about that? She's got a couple more chances back there.
Nothing
on the
we
table.
Can do about it now.
Okay, thanks a lot, Libby. Take it away. It's got to go. Let's get back to the table. Come on, Frank. Come on, Jill. Yeah. Right, okay. We only have one more, then we're down to the final three. Now then, we're going to have our last look at Casablanca. We're going back to Rick's place where the customers must have had some kind of a party. They're all seeing double for Frank and Jill. That is not all.
Are you Sam?
Yes, ma'am, I am. I'm Sam. Sam's your man, ma'am.
I'm looking for Rick.
I'm Sam.
Is Rick here?
No, ma'am. He's over there.
Is Rick here?
That's me, lady. Here's you looking at him, kid.
What do you want with me, lady?
Which one of you is the Rick that owns this place?
I am.
Look, this is important. You can't all be Rick.
Haven't you heard of the three-card Rick?
Listen, lady. We're the man you're looking for.
With one small exception.
We've all got problems.
This is stupid. Two of you are lying.
Listen, lady. Have you any idea how hard it is to talk with a matchstick in your gob? Not easy, you know. You know, lady, they call a man a liar is a sure way of feeling the back of his hand.
You're a liar.
Just feel the back of that hand. It's the washing up, you see.
What's a nice guy like you doing in a face like this?
My face, sweetheart, is my fortune.
Well, whichever one of you it is, John Huston wants him for a starring role in Hollywood.
Hollywood? Wood?
Hollywood.
That's what I said. Listen, blue eyes, and you two red eyes, this one's on me.
Yes, you're looking at me in terrifying. He really is so much like him, isn't he? Yes, this is Kenny Weimer. Kenny, well done. What are you going to leave then? Ken is the clue. What's that?
Well, the clue is what's left of the flower.
What's left of the carnation. Yeah. Now, listen, when you look so much like Humphrey Bogart like that, I mean, you never, of course, met the great man himself.
No, he died.
Yes.
24 years ago.
A bit before your time, yeah. Then, yeah. What about Lauren Bacall? Did you ever run into her at all?
No, only a double.
Oh, really?
She blew me out to Paris just to kiss her.
Oh. Just to kiss Laurent Bacall's double and then flew back.
Yeah, walk in, kiss the girl and walk out again, fly me back again.
And you picked up the check as well?
Yes, definitely.
What a way to fly. Lovely, Ken. But what about the rhyme? What does that say?
What about the rhyme? They thought they were headed for Hollywood until Bogey came to call. It was Bogey who walked out a star. I guess he said it all.
Now, that's the very last one we've got to think about.
What did he say?
Well, anyway, let's thank Kenny Weimark. Thank you, Kenny.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Take care. Thanks very much. What do you think, Jill?
Can we hear that one again, please?
You'd like to hear this one here, which was the documents brought in by Carl Rick, yes?
Yes, please.
Okay, Carl said the shopping list's been thrown away. That might arouse your fears. You could collect a lot in this, but will it lead to tears? Now, that was what Carl brought in. This carnation was brought in just now by Kenny Weimer.
Still written, that's it.
Yeah, well, we'll
reject that one, please.
Yes?
Yes.
Yes? You're unanimous about that?
Yes, please.
You definitely want to reject that?
Yes, please.
Getting a little bit like that.
Yes.
There we are, the final three on the table.
Close, and
yes, a bit close, Frank. We're going to reject the carnation brought in just now by Kenny Weimark, who said they thought they were headed for Hollywood until Bogey came to call. It was Bogey who walked out a star. I guess he said it all. So what are we rejecting this time? They thought they were headed for Hollywood till Bogey came to call. Well, could this be a trip to Hollywood? Maybe. Bogey, who walked out a star, I guess he said it all. Well, who walked out a star? Bogey. Who's the regular star of this show, and what a Bogey? Well, Bogey said nothing in the show, absolutely nothing. That's what you've rejected, nothing. Dusty Bin! Yeah! Hey. Come on, Frank. Go around there, Frank. Jill, just go around that side. Oh, they are so happy. Look at them.
Now, let me tell you, what's your little girl's name?
Victoria.
Victoria, and she's how old?
Seven.
She's seven, and you just told me a little while ago that she wanted you to win the bid, is that right? Would you look in there and apologise to her now, will you?
Sorry, Bob.
There you are. But they're so happy, I can't tell you. Let's get back to the table. Yes. Thank you, Fiona. Thank you. Take them away. Oh, yes. Magic, says Frank. We're down to the final two, Jill, so I can read both of these again. The glass was brought in by Mike Newman, who said, are they staying together, or are they ships that pass in the night? Can this really be love, or will everything turn out right? That is what Mike said. Again, the documents brought in by Carl Rigg. The shopping list's been thrown away. That might arouse your fears. You could collect a lot in this, but will it lead to tears? Show.
Well, the only one I was thinking about collecting a lot in, you could collect a lot in a car, you could collect a lot in the bin. Mm-hmm. You got rid of the bin?
Yeah, so I'll reject that.
We'll reject that one.
Yes?
Yes.
You don't really... Oh, yes, they're all saying around here.
Yes? Yes, yes, this one?
Yeah,
the glass.
You don't care because the rascal's gone now.
The rascal's gone.
You've got to take home a nice prize, so the glass has got to be rejected.
The glass is rejected, yes.
All right. Rejecting the glass brought in by Mike. Are they staying together or are they ships that pass in the night? Can this really be love, or will everything turn out right? Let's have a look. Stay together, ships that pass in the night. Well, they didn't look as though they were staying together in the sketch, did they? Can this really be love? Well, can this really be love? Is this a can? No, you know he's gone. Love, of course, could indicate nothing, or will everything turn out right? Well, if you'd have won this prize, Frank, everything could have turned out right, because you and Jill would have been going together, and you'd have seen plenty of ships that pass in the night on the deck of the Oriana on a fabulous two-week cruise. Oh! Now, look at this. You were going to sail from Southampton on the Oriana to Casablanca. Casablanca, then you'd have had a long day of sacred distance in Morocco. You would have gone to Alicante. Alicante in sunny Spain, you could have relaxed on the beaches of the Costa Brava. From there you'd have gone to Cannes, you'd have had a complete day there. Overnight stay to test the cuisine and your luck at the casinos. Of course, from Cannes you'd have come back to the Praia da Rocha for a day in the resorts of the Algarve, a short hop along the coast for a day in Grand Lisbon, the capital of Portugal, where you've had plenty of time to stock up with the final souvenirs, then another two-day cruise back home to Southampton and back there to Harborne in Birmingham. It's been rejected, it has to go. How'd you feel about that, huh?
Well,
I'm very travel sick.
Oh, you're very travel sick?
On a boat, Jill's sick on the Isle of Wight ferry.
Is that right? So have you ever had a cruise anyway?
No.
Never been away on a cruise?
No.
Oh, well, I believe
it would have been lovely.
It would have been. I can tell you, I've done one of those cruises around the Mediterranean. It really was a fabulous prize, and I'm sure you'd have had a terrific time. However, you've stuck with this one now. This is the prize, in fact, you're going to take home with you. The documents left by Carl Rigg. This was item number three. The shopping list's been thrown away. That might arouse your fears. You could collect a lot in this, but will it lead to tears? Well, now, shopping list thrown away, that might arouse your fears. Well, did you really think that was the bin? I don't know whether you did. You said you might have done a little while ago. Did you think they'd save the valuable documents? You also mentioned that, too, a little while ago. Well, you're right, Frank. You could have collected quite a lot in this. The tears that would have led to the whole tear coming down your eye would have been tears of joy. You've won tonight's Dar Prize, the Ford Festival car. Yes! Yes! Like it to sit in.
Good.
Come round here. That's nice. There it is. Oh, he's saying fabulous. Fabulous, he's saying. I say it's fabulous. And metallic paint as well. That can't be bad, can it, Frank?
Fabulous.
Well, you've been a terrific couple, as always, on 3-2-1. They're always marvellous people. Can I congratulate you, Jill? Look at her. She can't wait to get on the motorway. Sorry about little Victoria just losing her dusty bin, but Mummy and Daddy are coming home with a brand new car. That can't be bad. Plus the money you won in the quiz. What is it, Karen? £240. That's what it is. Fabulous. Enjoy it. I'm sure you will. Ladies and gentlemen, there we have it. Fabulous people, fabulous prizes. 3-2-1. Hope you have a good week. Take care. See you next week, everybody.